funniest, most interesting, and entertaining nights of the year. Everyone involved worked extremely hard to make sure all of you can enjoy tonight. We hope you all have a great time.
Before we begin the show, we would like to thank the administration for allowing us to continue to run this event. Without you, none of this would be possible. Another quick shout out to Mr. Bechet and Mr. Mand for all your help with the logistics and mechanics and for all your assistance with the boys. Because of you, they were able to see their vision come to life. We would also like to extend a thank you to Richard Lewis Formal Wear and Canning for donating the tuxedos that you will see on all the guys tonight.
We are very excited to see what talent these 8 guys will bring out. We have to give a special thank you to all the participating judges, Christina Gellin, Melina Pinto, Ms. Alexandra Lau, Ms. Nicole Eisenman, Ms. Laura Battaglia, and the first ever Mr. SHS, Jeff Pickett himself.
Lastly, we would like to thank our class advisors, Mrs. Strahan and Ms. Parker, for all their help keeping everybody on task to make sure we all have a great night. And now, let's hear a round of applause for this year's contestants.
Wow. Mr. SHS is up on Friday. Wow. This class? I don't know. It's Friday, and I've talked to maybe, like, Adam Potter, and that's it. Everybody else? Question mark. I've got to get it done. I got to get it done university, and I got to get it done fast. Mr. SHS contestants, assemble!
Do you realize I blow it that loud? I've literally been here the whole time. Am I really a question mark to you?
Good morning, SHS. Welcome to Nightline. My name is Adam Potter.
First nightmare, now what?
Cookies!
You called?
Pellegrini in.
Vice, what do you want? I have homework to do.
Hey guys, yo, we can show you guys a few moves.
Yeah, a little.
Mm-hmm.
A little.
Mm-hmm. And a little.
Mm.
Let's go. Thank you.
Hey, yo. Good evening, Stoughton High School. I'm your host, Jeremy Austin.
And I'm Sara Volmar.
And we have a question for you. Are you ready to find out who will be your next Mr. SHS? Yeah. I can't hear you. I said, are you ready? Yeah. All right. We have selected 8 highly qualified, extremely dignified, and swaggerfied men to run for the title. As you caught a glimpse of, it's going to be hard for the decision for the judges, wouldn't you say, Sara?
Oh, no doubt, Jeremy. It's going to be lit. Say it with me, seniors. Who's lit?
1-6.
Who's lit?
1-6.
Hey, all right. All of these competitors deserve to win, but I guess it's just a matter of who wants it more, or who can model walk best in the tux, whatever best appeals to our judges' eyes.
Sara, it's what's on the inside that counts.
Yeah, and what's on the inside of me right now is all the food I ate before this. On the outside is a smile, because it's holding back my birth.
I think it's about the time we introduce the contestants with the casual wear portion of the night, before your dinner comes out on stage.
Sounds like a plan. Let me just mention our hashtag on Twitter, Mr. No Period. SHS2K16 will be open all night. Tweet your fave moments during the show and we might just shout you out, starting now. With that said, how about we bring out Devlin Carroll?
Here is Devlin Carroll. He has what it takes to be the next Mr. SHS. He has been compared to the former Mr. SHS winner, Jeffrey Pickett, especially with that luscious head of hair. He enjoys flexing in the mirror and practicing wrestling with his dogs. Captain of the football team and wrestling team listed at a very generous 5'7", and I mean very generous. Fun fact, Devlin is the only member of his family that was not nominated for the best looking in high school. So he asked for your sympathy. However, he's still very successful with the ladies. He was born on the 4th of July and is still convinced that the fireworks and parades are for him. Devlin doesn't do much other than sports, hanging out with friends and school, as he wanted us to just keep going on with his bio and saying nonsense while he enjoys a few moments in the spotlight. Devlin, you can go now. And now our next contestant, Matt Medina.
All right, here it is, the moment you've all been waiting for. Here is Mr. Matt Medina. If you don't know him, maybe you know one of his other siblings. I mean, there's 10 of them. Matt is a 2-time Hockamock League honorable mention for football and wrestling. If he's telling you a joke, he probably stole it from a Vine he saw a month ago. Usually he listens to music, it's G-Eazy, but if it's not Drake, I mean, it's Drake. When he's not hanging out with his friends or listening to music, he's scooping ice cream at Crescent Ridge. Oh, and before he goes, he would just like to ask the audience to think a little on who they think may be a better Mr. SHS. Don't sell yourself short with the other contestants. Thanks, Matt. Now, here comes Jeremy's fellow big guy, Trevor.
Trevor? There you go. Trevor, standing at 6'2" and 190 pounds from the Dow School, most likely to be the next Mr. SHS. This man has all the skills necessary to be better than the rest. He has been compared to celebrities such as the one and only Morgan Freeman. He has his game time meal is milk and cookies, and at times a brownie. Every time he steps on the stage, the crowd goes wild over his amazing looks. During his spare time, he plays with his Hot Wheels, which he got at 5 years old. Trevor knows that he is going against some tough competition, but he is confident he will be the next Mr. SHS. Nice job, big guy. Now let's welcome on the next stage, the next contestant, Eric Levy.
Introducing Eric Levy, drum set extraordinaire, winner of 18 platinum hits, including everyone's favorite, Pop Cross Buns, Mary Had a Little Lamb, and Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. During the week, he practices his nunchuck skills in front of the mirror. Even with his hectic lifestyle, he makes time to hang out with his friends and plays with his favorite My Little Pony dolls. His favorite being the beautiful, majestic Princess Celestia. He plans to complete medical school and become a forensic pathologist in order to find out who killed his panda bunny Oreo in the battle of the bands with Jack Black and who is the second panda in command. Hopefully his panda buddies will show their support to their leader in the courageous battle of Mr. SHS and wreak cuddly, ferocious vengeance on his competitors. Eric Levy, everyone. Next up to hit the stage is the man, the myth, and the legend, Micah Pellegrini.
Man, I have socks taller than him. Up next is senior, Micah Pellegrini. Often confused as a kazoo kid, Micah is rocking a shirt without a stain on it and a string bag from his bar mitzvah. If you spot him in the halls, Micah is thinking of songs that describe... Micah is thinking of songs that describe what he sees. Micah is an aspiring basketball player as his large frame scares his opponents. In class, you find young Micah either on his trusty iPod, sleeping or eating, or usually a buffalo chicken sub. He is most commonly known as the kid on Nightline who can't read. Micah is a member of the tennis team and is usually wearing multicolored sweatpants and the jersey from freshman year. In his spare time, Micah is listening to the soundtrack of Star Wars, anything of One Direction's, or Meghan Trainor's No. When not adhering to his busy schedule, Micah is relearning the alphabet and attending church. Micah says he is enjoying the end of his high school life.
Thanks, Micah. Next up, your valedictorian wannabe, Adam Potter. Spot Adam in the halls, you are most likely serenaded by him with a varying mix of soul, R&B, and pop songs. He rocks his signature look consisting of various college t-shirts and anything with the color red, including his iconic lunchbox. His hobbies include wearing his backpack wrong, condescending your learning ability, and asking people to crump. In his free time, Adam enjoys learning the dictionary in order to maintain his 10.5 GPA and trying to locate a pencil on his crumpled piece of paper. Oftentimes, Adam can be seen copying someone's homework while simultaneously criticizing and correcting it. As a drum major and band president, he often ponders whether mayonnaise is really an instrument. Adam has also been a member of the ice hockey and tennis teams. His teammates have been quoted to say, "Why isn't Mark Sheehan playing right now?" And is the tennis ball supposed to land inside the court? Overall, Adam is a humble and kind peer who encourages his friends to live up to their full learning potential. That was Adam Potter, folks. Our next contestant is Maurice Dingle.
Maurice Dingle is an aspiring actor. He is enrolled in classes at Juilliard, so it is likely we will see Mo's face on a movie poster in the near future. Mo often sings to himself, hoping that Drake will stroll by and sign him to a record label. Since Mo has a love to basketball, you can consider Maurice as Stoughton's own Troy Bolton. In his free time, Mr. Dingle loves watching TV and hanging with friends. He is enjoying his last few weeks of high school. Mo Dingle.
Thanks, Mo. Last but certainly not least, Japheth Eloi. Here is Japheth Eloi, commonly mistaken for Japheth, 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 Jafar, Janier, and lastly, Bob. He enjoys dancing and stepping and is the captain of Exclusive. He spent his past summer creating all of Beyonce's moves and choreo. I won't tell that you said that. He is the reason Shakira's hips don't lie. Jay also enjoys running track and spends his weekend training with Usain Bolt. Awesome, Jay. Thank you. Wow, that is a great group of guys. I'm totally psyched to see their talents, although there would be no competition if I was a contestant.
Damn right.
Sara. Sorry to crush your dreams, but this isn't Mrs. SHS.
Yeah. I've heard it all before, and I'm not hearing it now. I'm gonna go ahead and introduce the guys. Is that cool, or? Okay. Are you guys ready? Oh, come on, guys. That was pretty pathetic.
I got this. Are you ready? No, I said, are you ready?
All right, big guy. I'm gonna need you to take it down. Three more notches. So I can bring out our first contestant and the most romantic bunch, Devlin Carroll and Matt Medina.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Hits from today and yesterday, Trevor and Eric.
Thank you.
There's some nice dance moves, Miss G, but I'm still taller.
Well, I think that shorter people are better because, you know, we're fun sized. Anyways, thank you guys for that sweet serenade. Now we will have Micah teaching music to kids who don't know how to play music.
Hello. I'm Micah, and I taught these two children how to play lovely music. They're working their hardest, so don't feel bad if you're better than them at music. I'm sorry. I taught them these instruments today. I've been teaching them real instruments. Do people want to see them actually play instruments well? Medina, just play that thing I taught you.
Thank you.
Thank you, boys. Jeremy, I think you should be the next one to take some lessons.
All right, Sarah, we'll talk about that in the back. All right. Introducing the next talent, Adam Potter, making his limp singing debut.
Yeah.
was like Whitney Houston was in the building with us right there.
All right, well, now we have Mo and Jay, and they got something special for you guys. Our last question, who is your favorite Disney character and why?
That's a good one. Code is a good one from Brother Bear.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with Simba from Lion King. Simba, you know, grew up a lion cub. Did that. Made his way up to the top, and now he's the king of the jungle, and that's what I'll be when I'm Mr. SHS.
Next is Matt Medina, escorted by Julia Bobek. Matt is wearing an Oscar de la Renta Twilight Gray wool and silk tuxedo with a matching Twilight vest, a Larbio Platinum Windsor band tie, and a matching pocket square, coordinating cufflinks, and of course, a pair of patent leather shoes. Let's hear it from Medina and Julia! Go forward or backwards in time?
Gee, wow, that's a great question. I mean, I'd like to go into the future, see this place rebuilt, see my Mr. SHS plaque up on the wall, also see where I'll be.
All right. If you're the architect for the new SHS, what two things must the new building have that it doesn't already?
All right, number one, a pool on the roof. Now hear me out. When the new freshmen come, the seniors can actually tell the freshmen that there's a pool on the roof, and there'll actually be a pool on the roof. Number two, there's going to be my name on the high school. Instead of Stoughton High, it's going to be my name. That's it.
And lastly, a genie grants you one superpower. What would it be and why?
Wow. These are great questions. One superpower. You know, I'd like to fly. I mean, I don't have a car. I mean, I have my license, finally. I mean, well, most likely to bum a ride, but I won't have to bum one anymore if I can fly.
Thank you, Matt Medina and Julia Bogart.
All right, next up, we have Trevor Dubovy, escorted by Katrina Joyce. Trevor has on Calvin Klein gray legend, matching leather gray pants and vest, a super soft microfiber shirt combined with a Labrio necktie and pocket square and patent leather shoes. Let's hear it for these lovely people. Of your head or ears on your hands, and why?
I'd say ears on my hands because I can look around the corner and I can see if someone's talking about how good I look.
That's good. If you could be in a movie of your choice, what movie would it be and what character would you play?
Honestly, SpongeBob SquarePants movie. And I'll just be SpongeBob, because why not?
Yeah! Alright, SpongeBob. Name the absolute best breakfast cereal and explain why it's better than the rest. Name the absolute best breakfast cereal and explain why it's better than the rest.
Honestly, I'm going to say Reese's Puffs. I've grown up many years eating meals from Reese's Puffs. And I've enjoyed them, and they're really good. So, this is positive.
Thank you, Trevor. Can we hear it for them, please?
And next is Eric Larry, Levy, escorted by Nicole Baudet. Eric has on a
contour double lapel jacket with a traditional matching formal pants, classic pleated shirt. But he has on an uplifting fashion pink vest and bow tie. And at the bottom, Radio City tuxedo shoes. Are you a cat or a dog person?
Cat!
I'm both. This isn't a question. You can't answer if you're a cat or a dog person. You're both. You can't, but if I would say...
Did they ask you?
I would have to say... cat dog.
Thank you, Eric Levy and Nicole Baudet.
By the lovely Izzy Hobbs. Micah has on a classic notch tuxedo from After Six Formal with matching pants, a microfiber white laid-on collar shirt, a solid black verbal vest by After Six Formal, and a very bold saffron-colored tie and pocket hanky just to add the right pop of color. At the bottom of it all, the Nouveau Shoes by After Six Formals. Okay, Micah, first question. For a year, you have to live as a fictional character from a novel. Who would you be and why?
Well, if I had to pick any character from a novel, it would obviously have to be PETA from The Hunger Games. Because he's played by Josh Hutcherson. Like me, he has luscious blonde hair.
If you become principal of Stoughton High School, what would your first movie be?
Well, if I were principal, this is a tough one. I'd have to say I would give each of the teachers I currently have a raise, because don't they deserve it?
I'm sure they'd appreciate you for that. Last question, would you rather only be able to whisper or only be able to shout everything? Explain.
I have to say I'd rather shout, because then everybody can hear what I say, because people say I'm already whispering. So I'd be already, I wouldn't do that anymore.
Let your voice be heard, Micah. Thank you.
And next is Adam Potter, escorted by Taryn Bates. Adam Potter has on a Calvin Klein Astron, a Satin trimmed lapel with a trimmed pocket flaps, a super soft microfiber shirt, a Virgo Passion purple vest and a matching bow tie, traditional patent leather shoes by After Six Formals. Unable to answer any questions or unable to ask any questions?
Well, if you've had a class with me, you know I ask many questions, some of which being multi-pronged questions. So I probably have to go with not being able to answer any questions.
What advice do you have to offer the incoming freshman class about the Stoughton High School?
So I have three pieces of advice. The first of which being be yourself. High school's a place where you can really find who you are. The second is try everything, every extracurricular. Don't limit yourself to one or two. Try as many as you can. And the last one would be is always bring a pencil to class, because you don't want to ask your friends for pencils in class. It's not fun.
If you were stranded on a desert island, who would you want to be stranded with?
Well, none other than Miss Lovely Taryn over here. She's funny, caring, kind, she's beautiful. So who wouldn't want to spend her time with
her? Thanks. All right, thank you, Adam Potter and Taryn Pace.
Next up, we have Mo Dingle, escorted by the beautiful Tanya Stanley.
So you can cut it up, dip it, boom, 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 and I'll be all set. Thank you, sir.
Next question. What are you going to miss the most about Stoughton High after graduation?
I'll miss everything. You know, hanging in the hallways with my friends. You know, this is fun, you know what I mean? I'm excited for college, but I'm really gonna miss high school though.
I love you, Mo. I love you, Mo.
Last question. If you were an animal, what would you be and why?
I'll be a dog. And let me explain again. I have a dog at home. He does whatever he wants, laying down and stuff like that. And when people drop food, he's the fastest one in the kitchen to go get it. So, that'll be me. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Mo.
And next is Japheth Eloi, escorted by the one and only Chanel Ford. Traditional shawl lapel tuxedo by After Six Formals. The Trevino shawl is one of the oldest formal schools in existence. Known as the original formal coat, it's matched up with the fuchsia vest and a tie to add fashion to the classic, and is also has on Radio City shoes for this evening's fashion. Japheth, What is the last thing you ate? Can you describe it like a waiter at a restaurant?
The last thing I ate. Okay, I'll see. Should I include the drink too? Because, you know, it's not a meal without the drink. So, you know, it's a beautiful little, like, glass full of, like, purely, like, purified water. We throw a little bit of lemon in it for some taste, because, you know, we don't want the metal to, like, get into the water. So, yeah, I had some water. And then after that, for the meal, you know, I had this beautiful, like, little, like, triangle, like, size thing. And, like, it's, like, thrown with a little bit of oregano on it. And, you know, it's really good. It's, we call it pizza. I don't know what you guys call it. So, you know, that's kind of what I had, a little bit of pizza and tap water.
Sounds delicious. What's the best decade? The 60s, 70s, 80s, or 90s, and why?
90s! Most definitely 90s! Because, I mean, like, come on now, 90s baby. And whoever said that, I love you right there. I'm not crisscross, you know it. And, like, think about it. All those styles out there, that, those parachute pants, you know you want a pair of parachute pants. Come on.
You already know. All right. What is your favorite song and why? Do you want to sing it for us?
Favorite song. Man, there's so many, man. Like, I don't even like. You wanna like give me a genre to tell you? Like, I can do everything for you. I can do a little bit of everything for you. I can do a little. I can do a little bit. Come on. You know, I can do a lot for you. What you want? Like, what do I want? What do you guys want? One person. I can't. Somebody gotta step up and say it. You want Drake? Okay. I'll give you some Drake.
Call me on your cell phone. Late night when you need my love. Call me on my cell phone. Late night when you need my love. And I knew when the hotline bling, that could only be one thing. I know when the hotline bling.
Okay, so yeah, so I'll do that. Because, you know, it's the fans.
It's all about the fans. Thank you, Japheth and Chanel.
And thank you to all the contestants for their thoughtful, unique answers. Only thing left to do for the closing act and announce who won what. Before that, we're going to take a brief break from the competition and to read some of your tweets.
It's now time for the closing act.
Hey, hey, we're back by popular demand. Let me get... Guys, I'm gonna redo this later, but we're closing out.
Bring them out. It's hard to yell when the background's in your mouth. Bring them out. Bring them out.
Coming live from the VIP. Heard the nightlife, lost life with that mean. Hold his bed to the same, wanna see my knee. The whole city got this hurt, he got three. That up, got a hip, but shout it, he not out. Who said the city on fast?
Greetings, love.
Greetings, love. Yes, sir.
Jingle Bell Rock.
Continue with the show. We have a special tokens of appreciation for our Boys, they all work so hard and are winners at heart, even though some of them may be losers on paper.
Until we call the next thing.
Your most enthusiastic, Japheth.
You know, Jeremy, I think if there was an award for best award show co-host, you would definitely win.
Aw, thanks, Sara. How sincere. I think I'd win, too. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for.
It's time to announce Mr. SHS 2016.
Drum roll, please. And the winner is... The winner of Mr. SHS 2016 is... Devlin Carroll! coming, though.
Once again, my name is Sara Volmar.
And I'm Jeremy Austin.
Eat your veggies, stay classy, and have a good night.
This is Courtney Wiener on the stage with the new Mr. SHS, Devlin Carroll. Devlin, how does it feel to be the new Mr. SHS?
It's quite a club we got. Jeff Pickett himself is in this club, and it's pretty prestigious. I'm glad I'm out on top.
So why did you decide to compete in the competition?
Once I started freshman year, I thought it was wicked funny. So I was like, hey, senior year, can't wait to do this. Can't wait to get it going, and that's why I did it.
What do you think was the best part of your performance?
The best part of my performance? I'd have to say me and Matt doing that. I don't know. I just enjoyed being out there. Or, you know, maybe even doing that for Micah, because Micah kind of rallied last minute for his talent, and me and Medina had to step up, and I thought it was funny. All
right. So now that you've won, what is one thing you're going to do with your new title?
I'm going to Disney World.
I knew you were going to say that. So what was the overall experience like? What are you going to take away from it?
There's a little procrastination by us, but we had a hustle the last final days. Me and Medina had to whip up a video. You know, it was just good stuff overall. I don't know. Great to be with those guys. Got closer to them. That's it.
All right, and I have one last question for you. Is there anyone you'd like to thank?
I'd like to thank Bice, Mr. Han, the advisors, Nick Quattucci, Taryn, Izzy, Katie, Sam Alley, all of them, and especially my main man, Medina, for going through it with me. We kind of like picked it up, and it was just good.
All right, thank you, Devlin. Congratulations.
Thank you.